Hey guys, Steve Tristan here, and today we are going to go on a little trip for a few days. We are going to go to where? The National Hardware
National
Show.
National Hardware Show in Las Vegas.
Yeah. Have you been to a trade show before?
Yes.
Yeah, where?
Two? One in Nevada and one here in California.
Ooh. Yeah? Yeah. Okay. Construction related, I think the other ones were, right? So the National Hardware Show, you know, is mainly for hardware stores, you know, like Ace Hardware, True Value, Home Depot, Lowe's, all of those places purchase products from the suppliers at this show. So we're going to go review some products and check out the show. And I think that it'll be really cool. So that way we can share these products with you guys and be able to, you know, see what's new, what's hot, what's awesome, you know, what's amazing. You know, are you excited?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why?
Because a lot of tools.
Tools? You like tools?
Yeah.
Yeah? It's kind of like going to Bass Pro Shops.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I have a story. I have a story. Yeah. Yes. Yes. So the story is that DIY Aidan, the first time we went into Bass Pro Shops together a couple years ago, you know, we went and saw everything, and the first floor, we saw the tank with the fish in it and everything, went upstairs, saw the camping equipment, and shot the toy guns, and then we went over to the real guns and the crossbows and all the cool stuff. And then we're coming down the stairs, and Aidan looks at me and says, he looks around the whole place and he goes, "Dad," he goes, "I love this place." No, how did you say it?
He said, "I love this place."
No, you said, "Dad." You said,
"Dad, I think I'm a man because I love this place."
So that was an amazing feeling. It's like, yes, I think I did at least one thing right. So anyhow, guys, we need to get going. We're going to head over to Las Vegas. We're going to drive over right now. Okay. So thank you very much, guys. And take
we're
care. And
here.
We'll see you. Yeah, we're going to leave
we're
you
leaving
here.
You here. Bye.
See you. So we're off to
the Wizard
to go see the convention center. Well, everybody, Steve Tristan here from Steve Tristan's Best. I'm here with
DIY Aidan.
And we're actually finally in Las Vegas at the National Hardware Show. So we traveled out here and we're right in front, just about to go in. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Yeah? We had a little bit of trouble getting in or getting his badge, but finally we're good. You know, guys, before we get started though, do me a favor and go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet. And so let's go ahead and go on in and have a good time and see what kind of products and companies we can find. What do you want to look for?
Knives.
Knives?
I'm just kidding.
he's suddenly always just wanting knives.
I'm messing.
I mean, is there anything?
Tools.
Tools? What kind of tools?
Everything pretty much.
Everything?
Yeah.
Okay. It's cool. Well, let's have a good time and let's
get
going.
See you guys in there.
All right.
Let's go.
You gonna follow us?
What in the world?
Okay, is it a big enough booth? Look, show floor, look how big it is.
Dang.
We're on one end, but...
Well, guess we should start here.
Yeah, we can.
Hot glue.
I know Rubber Toe's going to enjoy that the Eco Flow booth over there. Look at that, all the way over there. All right, so we're going to walk the show.
Laser measure clothes. Huh. Interesting.
We use a hot glue gun a lot. Laser measure, I don't know.
This is thick.
Look at this.
Wow. Can I try it?
It's like fancy. Like.
You can hire it. Put it back up. What is this thing, huh?
That's the glue gun, dude. Don't use it. It might come out at you. What?
Oh, my God. It's right there,
is it
too.
Asian?
Right there, too.
They got some weird stuff.
Yeah, it is.
Some unique products here. Screwdriver kit. These.
Dang.
What is this? Oh, this is the handle for the... For the screwdriver.
Pressure washer over there.
Wow. Is this one rubber?
Yeah, look.
Oh, cool.
And it changes color, right? Okay. How do you change the color, Robert?
Hold on, turn it on.
Not that one.
Oh, similar?
You have this one?
Yeah.
This is you guys are...
this is launching this week.
Okay, good.
It's a hybrid formula caulk.
Mm-hmm.
Which is a very advanced caulk formulation. It's waterproof, extremely durable, a lot of adhesion and bonding power. It's cleanable.
Okay, so it's interior?
Interior, exterior. And exterior.
Okay.
It is UV resistant. When you look at different types of caulks, whether it's latex, acrylic, silicone, they all have certain downsides.
Sure.
The hybrid formulation has a very, you maximize the benefits of several types of caulks.
Right.
And you limit the downside.
Okay.
So, if you're a layperson going into the store looking for a caulk, you don't know what you want, the flex caulk would be a great choice because it's going to work on a very wide variety of applications.
Good.
The other part, and I'll let you do this, Steve, is you do not need a caulking gun.
So I see that, yeah.
So it's in a pressurized can, has an adjustable trigger flow nozzle.
Right,
so, yep, you can put it right there, depress, kind of match your speed to the output.
Wow.
And you get a perfect bead every time.
It's easier to use than having to go all the time.
Very easy to use. The other part
That's
is,
good.
You know, what stays in the pressurized can does not go bad. So,
good.
You know, where the traditional cartridge, you're probably going to throw out
drywall
a bunch
screw.
Of products. this stays preserved in the can for future use.
Good.
And it's available in black, or I'm sorry, in white and clear.
White and clear, okay.
Yep.
Cool.
So yeah, that's our hot new product coming out this week.
Sounds good.
Stay tuned to YouTube. Probably around Thursday, there'll be an awful lot of
there's
coverage
my
on it. Thank you.
So check out our channel. If you subscribe, your video will be on there for the show.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Maybe on a short as well.
Okay.
So.
Awesome.
All right.
Thanks for coming by again.
Thank you.
Take care.
Pleasure meeting you.
Have a good show.
Hey, how are you?
Okay. Going this way.
Wow.
Well, when you say hello, you're just being really nice,
so
that's good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You guys enjoying the show?
Yeah, it's good. We just got here, actually.
Oh, well.
We had a meeting this morning, and we just like, okay, we got to hurry up and get to the show.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. So tell me about you guys.
Actually, we're influencers on YouTube.
Oh, my gosh.
We do a father and son, father.
Yeah.
That's
you know,
so much fun.
Handyman type.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
That's great.
Also, he has a section on how to be a man for teens and kids.
Wow. Most people are.
Just to navigate through things and
yeah.
probably just...
Well, through arduous, we said through arduous work.
Yes.
Yes. Oh,
so. Can I briefly tell you about our product?
Sure. Yes. He's videoing us too, so.
Hi, my name is Stacy. Let me tell you about the paintbrush cover. We have so many wonderful products. As you can see, we were on Shark Tank and the product here, the paintbrush cover. So if you're painting, you want to take a break, go have lunch, and you want to put the brush in here so it'll stay wet. and it won't dry out. So if you're taking
what about if I left on Friday, came back on Monday?
It'll still be wet and ready for you to go back.
Really? In. Okay.
So it's up to like 30 days so that it can stay in
30
here.
Days. Wow. Okay. Yep.
And you can close it and it'll stay wet. So when you cool. want to follow up with your project again,
sure.
just take it right out of the container and
awesome.
Start painting. And again, the same concept applies with the
rollers.
Roller. Oh. So if you're rolling wow. and you have to run an errand, go back to the hardware store and get paint, just put the roller right in here.
And these are for like artists?
Yes, this is the latest and greatest, the artist edition here. Again, you know, with the paintbrushes, little paintbrushes, you put them in here, this pops open, you slide them in, they'll stay wet. So again, you take that break, you want to come back and start your project.
So starting with this one, what does this one retail at in the stores?
This one is at $19.99.
And then the other two?
This $4.99.
Uh-huh.
And this one, like, $7.99.
Okay, so it's affordable.
Yes,
and where can consumer find it?
Consumers can find it on Home Depot.
Home Depot.
At Lowe's, Sherwin-Williams, True Value.
Excellent.
Or good deal. Our website, thepaintbrushcover.com.
Sure. Okay, good.
We also have new products coming in. These fantastic biodegradable gloves.
Excellent.
So that's a fantastic addition. And also we have one more. So if you're tired of searching for that garbage bag and you don't want to search anymore,
yeah,
this product called Garbage East can save you time, step storage space, it's quick, easy to inventory, no more searching for a bag.
So you have multiple sizes, basically.
Yes.
Oh, and it cuts off there.
So you always have a new bag.
If you had a taller one, yeah, there you go,
right.
I get it.
So you can use it in your bathroom, your office, put it in your car, I have one in my car. And then it's conveniently stored in the bottom of your garbage pail.
You guys are innovative.
Yeah. So they're going to be easier as well.
Sure. Well, if you'd like to send us a sample, I know I could probably use that one.
Sure.
And we could do a video on it. And I have my daughter's an artist. So I could have her like use this and she's doing a painting or something and put it on her YouTube channel. So
that would be fantastic.
Yeah. There's a PO box there. What's that?
You guys are marketing work.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to scan
sure.
if you don't mind. That would be great.
It's called Steve Tristan's Best. That's my name. And we started with my businesses and doing how-tos, but then I brought my son on. And his new first name is DIY. DIY Aidan.
forgot my last name. It's just DIY.
Love that.
Oh, that's great.
And so there's a lot of sections to our channel. Like we even have our faith in there too. So, but
yeah.
The big thing that he's also doing is how to, you know, teach young people how to be men.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
that's wonderful.
Yeah.
The majority of people I see, they're just
on their phones.
All the
right.
Time. Yeah.
So.
Just to interact and engage with other people.
Yes.
Yeah, because people don't even know how to do that nowadays.
Right.
Oh, we're videoing everything. He put up the Christmas lights this year for the first time. I was like,
that's great.
I'm not getting up on that ladder. I have bad hips. I have bad back. And then I was like, you know what? It's your turn. Go.
Oh,
and
great.
We just shot the video, and it was
yeah.
great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you guys do, like, how to change a tire? Things
we
like
haven't
that?
Done tire yet. Yeah. We did the windshield wiper blades.
Okay.
I haven't needed to change the tire yet. It's as we need things.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're just doing it as our life goes on. Hey, Steve Tristan here with Steve Tristan's Best. I'm here with DIY Aidan. And introduce yourself.
Andy Bachman from Louisiana Hot Sauce.
So, if anybody knows me, Louisiana Hot Sauce is like my number one thing. Cause like the best thing I love to eat is hard shell chicken tacos or bison the way my wife makes them. And we put Louisiana Hot Sauce on it. And so it's like I grew up that way eating that. And it's amazing that you guys are here. I came to the National Hardware Show just to get hot sauce.
To get hot sauce, exactly.
Yeah.
First time.
Yep. Wow. So you're going to try to sell hot sauce through the hardware stores or what?
Anybody. Yeah. They sell food, so we're trying to.
Yeah, hardware stores are selling
outside.
Oh, that makes sense. The grilling
there,
companies.
So
okay.
That's the tie-in with us.
Okay. Yeah. So what's your pitch here today?
Well, the pitch is that if you're going to eat
good.
And you're going to grill, you might as well have Louisiana hot sauce
in
your store.
Yeah.
It's a national brand. We sell it in all channels. The one we haven't has been hardware,
good.
Which is why we're at this show.
Yep.
And
good
it's
job.
Got a great price. This is never over $3.
Yeah.
So,
it's
I mean, especially
affordable.
With the economy right now, it's a great product. been around for 80 years.
Man, you guys are making me hungry.
It's pretty much, if I remember the formula, it's like cayenne pepper, vinegar, and salt, right?
That's it. Yeah,
three ingredients. Water. Very simple. And water, obviously. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. We're moving into the hardware scene. We're trying to get into the natural world as well.
Cool.
So, yeah, we just thought it would be a good idea to try this show and see if we could open up the door to some new customers.
Good deal. Well, thank you very much for the free bottle of hot sauce.
Absolutely. It carries it. Safeway, Vons, they carry it. Walmart also has it. So.
I mean, you said the same as Red
Rooster.
Red Rooster.
Another brand that you might see.
But it's exactly the same hot sauce inside.
I like the sort of leave the thing there.
Because Red Rooster is also at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles.
Yes. So that's probably where they're buying it. Probably
they use
it
wherever they are, wherever they're buying it from. Yeah. But yeah, so I for sure. So, all right, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
There we go.
We're playing some Jeopardy.
There you go. We'll add some to the video. Stop on one. Ah,
dick.
Keep going. Wait. Seven. Lucky number seven.
You get one each.
Oh, wow.
Popular with kids and dogs. So.
Okay. Cool. Thank you.
You're in the turbo.
You want it? Here, you can have it. Yeah, we'll give it to Turbo.
He'll rip it off.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, so this is our Tough Odor Eliminator by Grip Clean. This has enzymes built into the formula to actually eliminate the odor rather than cling to it and then linger all day long like some other competing brands.
Sure.
So it has kind of that new car smell, definitely a neutral smell.
Okay.
I wouldn't say it's like citrus or pine scented or nothing like that. So it's safe to use in your car. Safe to use, like if you have work boots.
Yeah.
We use it a lot for like motocross and stuff like that on our riding boots, our riding gear. I use it in my motorcycle helmet every once in a while. So just a quick spritz.
These are sample sizes? Or this
they are.
Okay.
Yeah, these are sample sizes.
How big is the bottle generally?
So we sell it here. 16 ounce sprayers.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, one spray goes a long way.
So how much is that MSRP or retail?
Press, what do we got these going for?
$9.99.
Yeah.
Where can somebody get
that? You can find this on Amazon. Amazon Prime, you can find this on our website, gripclean.com.
Okay.
I'm trying to think of where else we'd even... I think it's just those two spots current.
Okay.
So we also have a few retailers, like hardware stores and stuff like that.
Is that like your big seller right there?
Oh, it's starting to get pretty popular. Yeah, people like it. Yeah, a lot. So, like I said, like that one spray goes such a long way. This bottle lasts you quite a while. So.
And then this one here, you said the hand cleaner?
Yes, this is our flagship product. This is what we're most known for. So it's dirt infused. So it sounds weird, I know. But if you have an oil stain on your driveway and you put dirt on it, what happens, right? It pulls the oil out. So same premise on the skin.
Cool.
And so because we use like a pumice sand for the grit,
sure,
and we use olive oil, coconut oil type mixture,
right. This
we're able to get away with no chemicals and no solvents in our soap, so it's all natural. It's not going to crack and dry out your hands like some of the other orange cleaners we've seen over the years. So that's why we're a little different.
Okay, so on each of these, we'll take one sample of each, so that way we can test them out for you. We'll add it to the video.
Awesome.
Okay,
awesome.
And then that way you have it and we'll get you information so you can check it out
for
later.
For sure. What?
You won't tell.
I believe it's something that they put inside the bottle.
Magnets.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's the magnet?
I don't know what you guys are talking about. Oh, somebody came by this morning and waved.
It's physics.
They just came up and we just left it. Wow.
Promoting an opportunity to basically return your pet home safely, right?
Sure.
So it's another layer of identification besides the microchip.
Yeah.
And for the retailer, there's some profit margins that are available. And it's very unique. Everything's manufactured in Italy and different designs. So if you have pets, people love their pets and they love to buy gifts.
We have a lot.
Yeah. So no different here, right? It could be a collar, it could be a lead. These are ID tags to accessorize. And again, the basic element is the safety of the pet. And then we just happen to make the tags and they're pretty cool. So if you want to engrave a tag,
right?
So we have US flags, we have European flags.
Like
we have California, Texas. Oh. And so the idea is it's self-service. So by
he can do it, and not a guy behind the counter.
Exactly. Right. Yeah. So that's a value to to the store owners because now they don't have a resource. So after this, you scan the tag, right? And now it's going to tell your customer an opportunity to where to go to be able to put in. Now, some tags are two-sided, some are one. This is one side. So you just slide it in. And then now most of them go up to four lines, but you could be one or two for maybe a smaller tag like these, right? That could be two lines. Okay, so if this is for your pet, or it could be for you, right? It could be a luggage tag. So you could have your name and a phone number in case your luggage got lost. Doesn't always have to be a pet. So you want to put a pet's name? Two lines?
Just one, actually.
Well, you put turbo and then my phone number.
So you want a phone number too?
You put a phone number.
So we just go back. No big deal. And we just hit two. So I'll let you drive. Just tap it a little bit harder than it's an industrial screen.
That's his name, yeah. The next?
Yep.
Okay.
And then when you get to the numbers, just put a space or a dash for the phone number.
Okay. Pause.
You can't
my cell phone number. Sorry, I can't share it with the world. So.
All right, so there'll be another one that you're going to see the phone number again, so you don't want to do it. Okay, so now you have an opportunity for the customer in case they made a mistake, right? The phone number could be incorrect, the name could be misspelled, and then you have choices of fonts, right? So the top two are the two line, the Gaudi and the Helvetica.
The Gaudi?
Okay, then hit engrave. And that's it. Takes less than 2 minutes.
Cool. And you can come in now. Look at it work.
Wow. And then every tag would have an O-ring, so when you get home, you can just separate it, and this would attach to the collar.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Thank you.
So it's all together in one little kit. And again, everything is manufactured in Italy. So very unique design, very high quality.
Okay. So for the consumers right now, where can they go? Where do you go?
Pet retailers.
Pet retailers.
Yeah. So it could be a Pet Sense, it could be a Pet Land, it could be a Farm and Feed, it could be Ace Hardware, So
they're all over.
It could be shelters. I mean, we have shelters, we have veterinarian clinics, so our product fits where pets are, basically.
Cool.
Yeah.
Wow. Can they go to your website to find where the stores are, or they don't have
they
that?
They can. There's a store locator.
Okay.
They just search, put in your address, and you can find it on myfamilyusa.com.
Myfamilyusa.com.
Cool. I like it.
Awesome.
Amazing.
That's great.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a good one.
You too.
Thanks. Steve's phone number, so make sure nobody sees
it. Nobody can see it. Nobody can see it.
Show them the flag on the flag. So Dingo's got a
Turbo. Yeah.
Turbo. His name's Turbo. We call him Dingo. Because, he's an Australian cattle dog.
He's bred.
So they are bred with dingoes. Yeah. He's wild, but he's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He loves to play ball all the time.
Yeah, probably pretty active pet, I would assume.
The ball over and over and over again.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a good boy.
Our cameraman can relate.
Yeah. We do our how-tos on YouTube. So he and I, father and son. So
all right, well, good.
Yeah, it's cool. So all right.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate
Thank
you.
Take care.
Is there anything specific?
General. No. What are you guys selling?
Oh yeah, sure.
Is that a pencil? No, it's a shovel. All
right. Sure.
So
yeah.
So what do you got? And where can you know? So yeah, what do you have? And then where can people buy them? Basically, that's pretty much it.
Yeah. So I think for us, you know, we're Imakasa. We do, everything is manufactured in El Salvador. So we do mostly long handle tools. So you see like shovels, axes, rakes.
Cool.
And we sell through distributors in the US. Mm-hmm. So, but you can find us in under the Hart brand for Walmart.
Okay.
We do a lot of private label work as well.
Okay,
so,
cool.
Yeah.
So general public, if they find our video on YouTube, they could go to Walmart or maybe Amazon or no?
No, we're not on. No, and under Walmart, we're just under the Hart brand.
Hart brand.
We're not under Imakasa. But yeah, you'd have to. It would depend on where you were. We have different distributors located around the country.
Sounds good. You guys got some machetes there too, huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we have two. Imakasa is the parent company. We do some machetes and bladed tools. But we also have Condor tool and knife, which is specific to knives.
So this one is very interesting to me.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Put your head on the block.
Yeah. Yeah, we have machetes for pretty much harvesting every kind of crop you can imagine.
That looks like it's specialized for a specific kind of crop, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I have to double check exactly what that one is. I know this one, the flat one, is for corn.
Okay, so anybody on the channel, on your comments, tell us what this is for. Anybody in El Salvador who knows what this crop is for? Is it for, you know, coffee beans? Is it for, you know, corn? Who knows what it's for, right? I don't know, but I like it. It's really cool. And it has this flat piece here. So then you have the hook too, to hook on the other one next to it. But this one, for some reason, good deal. Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
It's a lawnmower, and they also have a vacuum, I think.
Crazy. Can I start it? Don't run over the dog.
They also have a dog, too.
Please don't run over the dog. Run over the pet. No.
That's pretty cool. I saw these guys in Sweden.
Yeah?
The palace. I was wondering, oh, that's why they don't have Mexicans here. Got these robots.
Yeah, man, they're taking over. Gardeners. Hey, look at me. Look.
Do you mind?
Gardeners, guess what? You're out of a job. They have your replacement right there. What do you think, DIY Aidan?
I feel bad for the guys that are losing their jobs.
Yeah, me too.
Because I'm a gardener too, sometimes.
Yeah? Sorry. I was just joking with them, saying that all the gardeners are out of a job now. So
yeah,
because this is amazing.
Thank you. Yeah, these are the robotic lawnmowers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and you can control just through your phone and the satellites. Yeah, you control the machine automatically.
With satellites too?
I mean, the satellites only for the GPS.
Okay.
So for example, this is the RTK station. Yes.
Okay.
And and then we have a solar panel, and it connects, it transmits a signal to the satellite, and then the satellite transmits a signal back to the machine.
Okay.
Yeah, and they can follow. Yeah, and then they have the GPS to.
So this one is a vacuum or a mower?
Mower. They're both mowers.
They're both mowers. Okay.
Yes. And so for this one, we have a 3D vision. You can see
You see the camera.
Yeah, the camera, 3D vision, and we have three ultrasonic. We have three ultrasonic sensors, and then we have a physical bumper. You can see in the front.
I see it.
Yeah.
The bumpers. Yeah.
Yeah, and these are all the protections.
And it comes back to the charging station.
Yes, exactly. And they can protect the machine and also protect the child and the pets. So the 3D vision just humanize.
Right. I see.
Yes. Yes.
So I have a question. How big of an area can it cover for one charge?
One charge. It's for about 2.5 hours.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, 2.5 hours.
So that's a big yard.
Yes. And so for the yard, so we have different sizes. So we have that one is Luba and that one is Yuka. So for this one is for larger long sizes.
Okay.
Yeah, until from 1,000 to 100,000 square feet.
Wow.
Yes.
So where can someone buy this now currently?
On Amazon.
Amazon.
Yeah, I can search my motion and then you can buy the product.
Excellent.
Yes.
Okay. Well, he's videoing and it'll go on our YouTube channel.
Yeah, sure.
And then so I'll give you my card so that way you guys can find us. If you subscribe to our channel, it'll alert the National Hardware Show.
Okay.
The full video won't come out until probably another week,
mm-hmm.
But we'll be doing some shorts too, and this might be one of the ones we'll put a short on.
Okay, thank you so much. And also, we also want to have an interview with you. Sounds great?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay. So I do have some questions. We can say hi to the camera first.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, my name is Steve Tristan. We're with Steve Tristan's Best, and this is DIY Aidan. We do how-to on YouTube for father and son.
Uh-huh.
So,
that's your son?
Yeah, I know. He's my son.
He looks so young, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, thank you. Yeah.
No worries.
Yeah.
And so I do have some questions I want to ask you.
Sure.
Yeah. So do you usually need to mow your lawn? How often?
He does. every Saturday, yeah?
Every Saturday? So only once a week to lawn your mow?
Once a week.
Yeah. Wow. And what type of lawnmower do you use? Have you ever used robotic or just
traditional?
Oh, the traditional, the gas power one. Okay, so have you ever thought about maybe you will switch to the robotic lawnmowers one day or in the future?
Maybe, but we have two areas, and we have a retaining wall in our house.
Uh-huh.
So, and there's a fence, so the other, basically it's front and back yard.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Is it
so
like
the robot, we would need to move it to that area, or we'll have mm-hmm. two. If we did that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, one in the front and one in the back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Yeah. And yeah, so thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
So, well, how much do these run? How much do they cost?
It depends on the...
The so big for, one over there, that's the biggest yeah, over there. How much
actually,
is that one?
This one, that's Yuka and that's Luba. They're actually two different machines. So
right.
for that Yuka, can you see like the sweeper kits?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So for the sweeper kits, it can collect the debris.
Okay.
And then it dropped the debris automatically, and
okay.
then go back to the charging station.
Where does it drop the debris at?
Here, you can set. You can like.
You set up.
Yeah, you can set it. You can set it by yourself, and you can choose anywhere
to
dump
drop
the.
It.
Yeah, to drop
okay,
it.
Okay, then you just pick it up.
Yes,
I see. Okay.
Exactly.
I,
yes,
that
it's
makes
very
sense.
Convenient.
Yeah,
yeah.
It sounds great.
So for but the sweeper kit, you have to buy it separately. So it's like $300.
Okay, how
yes.
much is the units though?
The units. So for this one,
mm-hmm.
we have we're starting from $2,099
mm-hmm.
until $4,099.
That's the bigger one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And for that one.
And in the long term, those prices are going to go down.
Yeah.
Just like everything, they will.
Yes.
It's
yes.
like everything else. Everything
yes,
will go
exactly.
down. So
yes.
We don't want people to be like afraid of like, oh yeah, this brand new technology, it's expensive. But
yeah.
you look down five
yeah.
years down the road, it's going to be $1,000 less.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And for that one, starting from $1,399.
Okay.
To $1,999.
Okay.
Yeah. Without the sweeper kit.
So that's the bigger one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That's for like small.
Excellent.
Smaller area.
So that's good. Well,
yeah.
Thank you very much for showing
no
us.
No worries.
This is awesome.
Thank you so much.
So what do you
thank
think? You got to express yourself. What do you think?
Oh, I don't know. Am I going to lose my job?
Go
yeah.
to Amazon and buy one.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Yeah. So yeah. are you guys YouTuber? Are you?
Yeah, we're YouTuber.
Oh, what kind of YouTuber?
How to? Yeah, DIY.
Oh, like only for the. What kind of, like, what type of?
For hardware.
Hardware.
For home improvement. For. Different products, like
uh-huh.
you know, how to what we do is DIY Aidan and I.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm his dad, so father and son.
Father
I teach
son.
Him. I
oh.
teach him how to do things on the YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, he has a special segment on how to be a man to
uh-huh.
teach kids and,
yeah, exactly.
and
mm-hmm.
teenagers.
Yeah.
One of the things he always says is, "Well, you always
they're most always, of the time always on their phone."
They're
usually always on their phones, slouching on their phones, and
yeah,
mm-hmm.
it's usually what they do. It's
so,
a waste of time.
Yeah, so we're teaching him what we call arduous work,
mm-hmm.
hard work, right?
Mm-hmm.
And in doing that, so it's great. It's
yeah.
It's been an interesting adventure.
I feel like you can
yeah.
learn a lot of stuff from your dad.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
yeah.
So, you're a good dad.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Thank you.
Thank
Take
you.
Care. God bless.
Bye.
You don't have your mic on.
Wow, look at that truck. Raptor, Ford Raptor. Nice color, too. Got your tools in the back, a nice solar panel. Looking pretty good. Look at that. Ah, got your wood back there, got all your stuff and your tools. Pretty nice.
Push me up.
Variety. Knives.
He's a dad. Knives. Okay, so we are on YouTube, my father, son.
Oh,
yeah. So.
Yeah.
Put on your thing so you can tell him what you do. Yeah. So you sell knives?
Yeah. We sell a lot of knives out here. They're including pocket knife, hunting knife, garden, machete. Yeah.
Out of everything here, which one is the number one special one that you
Oh, it's hard
like
to see.
Know,
yeah,
huh?
We have a lot of things here.
Okay.
Yeah.
The
manufacturer of over 20 years experience. So we have a lot of variety here.
Okay.
Yeah.
They have clips?
You have a YouTube account?
Yeah.
Oh, YouTube, huh?
Yeah, we're on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
So.
Maybe I can search you and follow you.
Yes,
yeah,
please.
What's your account?
It's Steve Tristan's Best right here.
Oh, Mac, have this.
And then if you want to send samples and us review them on our channel, whenever you have something new or whatever, you send it to us and we'll test it. You tell us, you know, what do you think you would want us to test it on, like,
hello.
As long as he's not, like, you know, throwing it across the house. Or
Test the
durability.
Durability test.
And with good of you.
Yeah, so we could do that for you if you'd like.
Hello.
Thank you so much. There's a PO box there. If you need to ship another way, let me know and I can get you another address. But this one should be good.
Okay. Good.
All right.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Done. So a family-run master's, a family-run company, 65 plus years in business, based out of Racine, Wisconsin. So these are our number one seller by far, manufactured in the U.S. still. So we still make these in Racine. These are our newer probes.
Oh, yeah, I saw the video. Do the flames come out of this one?
Oh, I saw that video too. That was, we saw that and we were like, oh, come on, what terrible timing. Never seen that before in our lives. That's and then funny. That happens. But yeah, so these are our number ones, mostly in industrial distribution. So your Grangers, Fastenals, guys like that. We have our own website, masterappliance.com, where you can get them, or our Amazon page.
On Amazon too,
Yep, that's good.
So what was the price range on this one?
These ones range anywhere from 185 to 205, depending on which platform you look at them for. So
good, and then you have some other ones here.
Yep, so these are our new Pro Heats. So these are a little more comfortable in the hand, a little bit lighter, still same output, you know, 1200 degrees Fahrenheit for both for max. Difference in these is how much customability you want in them. So base model is just your standard low, medium, high. Medium model, 4 airflow settings, 6 temperature settings. Or you can go to the top end, which is a full LCD. You can do 10-degree increments.
Okay, cool.
A bunch of different airflow settings as well. You can set programs. You can password lock it. Okay. So if you're working, like an engineering manager can lock it so his employees can't unlock it and do it. So.
Good deal.
So yeah, those are the...
What's the one on the end?
Masterflow?
Yeah.
So this is our heat blower.
Okay.
So this one's built with the brushless motor. It's designed for continuous use. So it's got 47 CFM, which is high airflow for heat guns. But this one, I mean, you can run 8 to 10 hours a day every day, nonstop, and it's going to work just fine for you. Okay, so it's built for continuous heat output. The big thing, too, with all these heat guns compared to heat guns just in general, they're all repairable.
Oh, really?
And so we sell elements, motors, cords, switches, all that type of stuff. And so they're all designed to easily be done in the field also.
Yeah.
So your downtime's minimal.
Cool.
And then we have a in-house repair service, too, if people want to send them in. So.
Cool. Well, thank you. That was awesome.
Cool.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys.
If you say anything, be y'all.
Right.
Yeah, we'll just
I'm
going to
put this here for now. Please do. Got the water.
So for what you guys do, if you're doing a lot of DIY and you're doing a lot of, do you do any car repair, any home repair?
A little bit. It's father-son, so it's whatever we're doing around the house or on the job
Okay. This would be your best friend. All of these products would be your best friends. So we have everything from gardening to nitrile to vinyl to welding to
EV. We use a lot of cordless drills.
Okay.
So that right there.
Impact.
Impact. Yeah. Yes.
So Impact. I can definitely send you some samples for Impact.
Sure.
Yeah. I'd be happy to do that.
Sounds good. We could test them out and you know, on different projects. And
yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And we only want honest feedback. So if there are things that could be improved, great. If you think it's awesome, fantastic. We want to hear that too. But we're all about improving for the people that actually use the product.
Sure.
And we are the manufacturer of everything that you see.
Okay.
So we don't have to go to somebody else's factory to make the changes.
Okay.
Okay.
And do you guys sell through other channels or do you sell direct? Or
we sell direct.
Okay.
And we sell through distributors. Okay. We do wholesale. We do end user stuff. Most of our e-commerce is on Amazon.
Okay.
So there is some, we don't have quite the volume of SKUs on Amazon, but yeah, we sell to end users all the time.
Good.
Yeah, absolutely. Awesome.
What else you got?
I got all the stuff and things.
Cool.
So we got lots of protective gear. This is like the best toolkit.
Looks so awesome.
It is so awesome. So several layers, and they're all specialty coated for high grip. So even if you're in an oily or wet or really nasty environment,
right?
These have high grip.
Under the house? Yeah. When it's leaking?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Or if you're working with mold, it washes off. And it doesn't retain any of those like little spores. So it's
excellent.
You would love that.
So what are the other layers underneath? What does it have?
I would like to lift that up for you, but I'm going to let you
know. No. Just tell us.
It's more of the same. So not more of the same, okay. But you've got, you've got your wrenches, you've got,
okay.
You've got hammers, you've got drill bits,
sure.
You've got tons of stuff.
Excellent.
And it's universal.
Good.
So it'll fit with anything that you guys have. Then we also have, of course, your head protection. We've got quite a bit for gardening tools. We do a lot of private label. So you'll see those are different labels than Rackshaw,
sure.
But we do a lot of private label for different companies.
And that's your ladder as well?
That is our ladder as well. That's our harness as well. You can see some more heavy duty.
So explain to DIY Aidan what that ladder is for. Why is it retractable, right?
It is retractable.
Yeah.
There's
easy storage, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep. Absolutely easy storage, but also you can, these little hooks in here, you can make the steps different heights if you need to.
Oh, cool.
So if there's something in between a project, because you know sometimes you're way too high or way too low, you can move
bring
these
it down
up
a little.
And down. And I would do that, but I have nails, so no.
Cool.
I would love to, but the answer is no. So, and I'll give you some swaggy baggies.
All kind of shaky, so we wanted to make it better.
Stronger, yeah.
So to do that, we made this right here longer.
So oh, good, yeah.
Everybody else is 18 inches. We made ours 23. So that takes a lot of the shake out of it.
Mm-hmm.
But what it also does, kind of a negative, it raises your minimum standing height from already kind of too high,
okay.
5 inches more. So to fix that, we made it, we could flip this upside down. If you watch the graphic right there, perfect timing.
Oh, for the bottom. Okay,
yeah,
there you
go. Yeah, so that gets you down to 10 inches.
Okay, good.
And then you can actually go a little above 6 feet. Obviously, we recommend some outriggers and clamps and guardrails.
Sure.
Because regular scaffolding, you don't
have. I think
what
attracted us the most was this. He was like, cool, I could, like, yeah, right.
Yeah, the other guys only fit on the ladder here.
Okay.
So that's not very useful if you're up high. So
yeah.
Put it on the guardrail. Make it where it'll go outside the guardrail, inside. You can
slide. So
you
can come off this side as well?
Not this side.
This side, okay. Just,
yeah,
that
just,
side.
Just the ends.
Right.
But you can put it on top. You can put it in the middle. Slide it along with you if you want.
We were on a job. He was up there, and I had to keep going up and down, bringing stuff.
Yeah.
That's what the young guys are for, though, right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
So, yeah. All right. Sounds good. Well, thank
good
you very
stuff.
Much.
The 5 foot unit over here, if you want to take a look at that, it's the widest.
Here's our YouTube channel, so your video will be on there.
Yeah, for sure. I'll, these guys are YouTubers, influencers.
Okay, what's up?
I can
Steve.
Pass the mic over to Chase here. He's
Tristan.
He's more of a marketer.
This is Aidan. He's known as DIY Aidan on our channel.
DIY Aidan?
Yeah.
What's up, man? Good to meet you. What's up, dude? Chase.
Yeah.
Pleasure. Well, you gonna clip this on?
Sure.
What are you doing, an interview?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, why not? I mean, he already started.
I gave a bit of a spiel about 6 foot guardrail.
What you want to know? Let me tell you about it?
Yeah, well, go ahead.
All right, so it's a 6 foot Baker scaffold,
okay.
Like you've seen a million times all over the place, right? And there's dozens of manufacturers.
Sure.
And they make, they all have their own version of this product, but they're all very, very similarly designed, almost identical with very minor changes. So what you're going to find is that almost all of them have an 18-inch side rail cut.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So what we've done is expanded it to 23. When you extend it to 23, you get more contact between the cuff and the frame. The problem is that when you drop this platform low, you've increased the platform height. When you,
right.
When you drop the side rail low, you've increased the platform height. So the breakthrough was the design feature that allows us to take that side rail off,
flip it upside down.
Down.
You showed us on the monitor there.
And go back on.
Good. Yeah.
So you can get down to 10 inches with a significantly more stable multifunction unit. Then we improved the safety in every way that we could. So
Okay, good. We
designed this triple locking mechanism. There's two interesting things about it. One is that you can remove it and flip it upside down, reverse the orientation of it.
Right.
The second cool thing about it is it's actually a lock. So every other manufacturer you see is going to have a latch. Ours locks. It's got a dowel pin here.
Right.
It'll keep it from raising.
Sure.
Any further than the platform can come out from underneath. And it is flush mounted in the plywood platform.
Mm-hmm.
So it falls down inside that plywood, so it can't be kicked out of place.
Okay.
And we include four of them
right.
instead of two, which is standard on every other unit you see.
Oh, yeah, that's better, for sure.
Yeah. And then we have some additional design features. We have offset ladder rungs to move the center of gravity inward.
Okay.
Because the most likely, if you're climbing one of these guys by themselves, the most likely direction for it to tip is this direction,
right?
When you're climbing it, when you're putting your weight on it. So we move those ladder rungs in just a little bit. That was okay. a subtle difference. The other design features you're going to see on the 6 foot unit are there to accommodate this stability kit. So there's three parts in a stability kit. You have a stability brace. So we had to add a backing plate and threaded portion here.
Yeah, I see it.
There is a, that obviously braces the corner, yeah?
Right.
Then you have what's called a caster lock. We had to weld a nut down here at the bottom of the frame.
Okay.
And this thumb screw will go in that nut. You still have your span pin, so you still have an integral connection. But we'll screw this into the nut. Oh, sorry. Yeah. And that's going to push that caster stem up against the wall
mm-hmm.
on the inside of the tube. And that's going to eliminate any of the sloppiness in the connection, right? And the last part is this rail cuff clamp. It's simple in design, four of them in the kit. And it's just going to push that side rail into that frame. Right?
Extra security, yeah. It's good.
It's just going to push it in. And when you add those parts, you get a multifunction unit that does not shake
okay.
like your traditional multifunction unit.
So where are your products, where are they sold?
We're going on shelves in Menards. At this moment, we're rolling out. Containers are coming in.
Okay.
We are online with Tractor Supply,
okay.
Northern Tool, okay. Lowe's,
okay.
and Ace Hardware.
Okay. So Lowe's doesn't have it in the store. It's
not in store
it's
yet.
It's only online.
That's right. You need to tell them you want it.
Good. Yeah, well, I didn't hear you. What was that?
You need to tell them you want it.
Yeah, for sure. There you go. So Lowe's, we need it.
Yeah, well, come on, Lowe's.
Hook these guys up.
They're North Carolinians, Lowe's. They're based in Charlotte.
Yeah, so for sure.
Fellow North Carolinians, if you see this,
it's good. Well, thank you very much for showing this. This is awesome.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
We have another business, so we use scaffolds all the time. We install window coverings. In new construction jobs, and there's always the loft units that are
yeah.
really high. So I own a scaffold, but it's not your guys's, but I want to buy one now. What does it run retail for an 18-footer?
18-footer, I want to say, is in the $900 range. Okay. This one maybe 950, something right. like that, approaching yeah. 1,000. This one's 800. 12-footer is 800. I just right. looked it up.
Okay.
We're priced a little bit higher on our website than our distributing partners.
Well, so obviously, I mean, you guys... It's safer for sure. All this extra, you know.
Well, no, I don't mean higher than competitors. I mean, yeah. we're higher than the retailers. So if you buy right. from Lowe's,
yeah.
you're going to get a little better price than if you buy from us. And that's because right. we can't sure. undercut our partners. Yeah. And they have
it's,
better.
It's a strong unit, though. I like it. It's good.
Thank you.
So
we've taken that same approach yeah. to every product in the lineup. So you see sure. these outriggers are the same as those outriggers, but you see the angles different. This is so that you climb a single unit. I told you this is the direction of tilt, right?
Right.
So yeah. you want these guys pointed towards you.
Yeah, and then that one's stabilizing it from...
That's for two way. Units.
Oh, that's
so when you go
units.
Up two units, the weight of the second unit keeps you from tilting it towards you. Your body weight does not affect it as much.
Okay.
Therefore, the most likely direction of tilt is on the sides
right.
rather than the ends, so we point them outwards.
Good deal.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, guys. So it's an amazing scaffold, right? So check them out at, what's your website?
Scaffoldmark.com.
Okay. Thank you very much, guys. Take care. God bless. And
see you guys next time.
Bye. See ya. So you guys want to explain what it is?
Yep.
He's okay.
He's never seen one of these before.
He's never seen one. Here's your mic.
Oh,
if you talk to him, I won't.
All right.
All right.
Here we go.
Here we go, guys. So this is a 27-ton hydraulic log splitter. So the split time is 13 seconds back and forth.
Wow.
Coolest feature about it is it actually turns vertical. So watch your feet there, right? So if you got heavy logs that someone can't lift, you can just throw them under here, and now you can split them vertically.
Amazing,
right?
Wow.
So, really cool. It has a 6.5 horsepower Kohler engine. So, 10,000 places that you can service your Kohler engine if you have any issues. 1 year warranty on manufacturer defects for our outdoor power equipment problems. 2 years on the engine.
Looks great.
Any questions? How did I do?
You did well. Where can someone buy this from?
You could buy this at Home Depot, Tractor Supply, Lowe's.
Good deal. So, you know, if we were cutting wood, I wouldn't buy one of these. I would just have you do it.
Yeah. Doing it by hand is more rewarding, is what I've heard.
So you have, you know, guns after, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, thank you very much.
No problem.
So we're obviously we're on YouTube. We have a father and son DIY. This is my son Aidan.
Hi.
My name's Steve, and our cameraman is also an installer for different products. He installs blinds and screen doors and things like that as well.
Okay.
We shot a video, a DIY video, with him, and he pulled out all this crazy safety equipment and this face shield and everything when he's doing everything. But he operated a chop saw using EcoFlow.
Yeah.
In the back of his pickup truck. And I'd never seen it before.
Yeah.
So if you check out our video, you could see how my reaction to it. And I was like, wow, this guy and all his gadgets, this is crazy. So could you explain your product and share with us, you know?
Yeah. You want to go specifically in river or?
We can start here and then we can go around the booth. Yeah. Whatever.
Yeah. All right. So yeah, you're looking at, this is our river series. It's kind of our entry level, kind of smaller. So you got, generally the size are going to be like 250 to 750 watts on these. So these are great for camping, outdoors. These can power power tools, you know, sure. Smaller power tools, recharge devices. So it's a very consumer friendly product.
Good. So, and then, so you have some larger models over here.
If you get back on the other side, you have our Delta series.
And these are for?
So this is, you're going to have a bigger use case, right? So this is going to be on the smaller end, more powerful tools. You're looking at maybe longer extended camping trips. Mm-hmm. This, you know, this is really looking, you can do not quite whole home backup, but you can, you know, if you want to keep a refrigerator running during a power outage, you can couple these together and create a whole home backup system.
Okay.
It is kind of our entry level product into the whole home backup category.
Sure. I noticed the bigger ones over there as well.
Yeah.
Those are for like full-blown homes.
Yeah. So yeah, the Delta Pro Ultra, that's whole home backup. It is still portable though.
Portable.
So that is our largest portable.
Can we go check it out?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sounds good. And these are the panels?
These are the different panels you can integrate. So these are the portable panels.
Okay.
This, again, for camping, kind of like outdoor, any kind of area where you don't have a permanent fixture, right?
Sure,
you can set these up quickly. This would be a 400-watt fixed panel. So, you know, this can be part of a rooftop array.
How do they mount it? They go in the brackets and everything?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So this can part of be a rooftop array. So you can, you know, this could be a system that connects up to powering a Delta Pro Ultra.
So you have this one.
All the same thing.
Yeah.
Three inverters, 15 batteries for 90 kilowatts. So that is, for most people, that is more than they use in a month.
Wow. That must be a really big house there.
That's a sizable system.
What is this unit right here on the wall?
So that helps integrate, you know, this is an option if you want tighter integration with your circuit. So this is basically a sub panel.
Okay.
And then, you know, there's an app that integrates with it. You can choose what's going to be backed up. You know, there's a lot of options designed to save energy. So you have quite a few different things that you can do, kind of a more intelligent solution. You can hook these up directly on a transfer switch.
Sure.
You know, if you want to keep it simple.
Okay.
But a lot of people really like having this full integration.
Right. Well, good deal. This is awesome. Yeah. I mean, as soon as I saw your product, the smaller version on the back of his truck, I was like, wow, this is really cool.
We just launched this at CS. It made a pretty big splash at CS, mm-hmm. and it's doing really well sales-wise.
It's good. So where can the consumer purchase these from?
So ecoflow.com as well as Amazon.
Cool. Good. I think that's where Roberto, that's his nickname, sorry, got his Amazon, right? So, okay, good deal.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, if I take a rest. Yeah.
Aidan, give him a thumbs up.
Yeah, I promise.
Los Angeles, we're not buyers, we're influencers.
Oh, okay.
We're doing, so your video, this video will be on our YouTube.
Okay.
All right, guys, so this is the National Hardware Show. We walked the whole show floor. We checked out a lot of tools and a lot of cool stuff.
Yep.
And so what do you think, Aidan? This is your first show?
I really enjoyed it. No, it's not my first show. I think it's my second show in Las Vegas.
Okay, but the National Hardware Show, this is your first show here?
Yeah.
For this one. So what do you think of it?
What a great experience here. I like it. It's a lot of variety of a lot of things. You find out a lot of stuff.
What's your number one product or booth that you went to today?
It's a tough one. I'd have to say
Well, is it the knives or the...
I'll go with the knives.
The knives? You like the knives. Okay. Yeah, what about you got Dingo...
There was these...
tags, right?
Tags. Yeah.
Dog tags. Yeah, that was cool.
Dog tags. That was great.
I honestly think the coolest thing I saw was the lawnmowers that are...
Oh, yeah, the lawnmowers.
AI is taking over the world, guys.
I'm going to lose my job.
He's going to lose his job as a gardener. No, you're still going to work hard on that. As a matter of fact, I'm going to buy him a brand new lawnmower. It's going to be the manual push kind, like in the 1950s. Yeah, before you know it, he's going to have these guns like this. What do you think, guys? Leave it in the comments to see if DIY Aidan builds guns with a push lawnmower, huh? A manual. You want to do that or no?
Yeah.
You serious? It's okay. Yeah. Anyhow, we had a lot of fun at the show. We really had a good time. Talked to a lot of cool people. Saw a lot of cool products. So, okay, guys, you know what? Do me a favor. If you want to see any of these products in the future, leave a comment. If you want to see any of their videos like this, just let us know. And be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and select the alert notification, right?
Yeah, all definitely.
Right. All right, guys. Thank you very much. Take care. God bless.
And we'll catch you guys next time. Goodbye.
See you next time. We'll be right back.